girl, why are you like dancing behind me? Can you back up? They are still interested in each other, and I think that's really sweet. Oh no! Oh my god, of course! Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. We're gonna be getting back into the 7 Deadly Sins challenge today. Last episode Last episode we actually made really decent progress. Like, Roxanne mastered her career. Lena aged up into a child. We had a really, you know, nice birthday for her. And we've moved Akira in as well. So last episode went, I think, pretty well. So I think all that we really have left to do for the challenge now is we have to finish her aspiration, just because there's one last little thing we need to do. And then we just kind of need to work on her relationship with Akira. And I think we're set. I think we're good. So I think in this episode, we're going to keep focusing on getting Akira and Roxanne's relationship kind of back to where it was. They're still not 100%. I mean, they live together now, but they're still not in a relationship. They're still kind of working through like the awkward tension. But I think in this episode, we're really going to focus on building their relationship back up and possibly maybe even getting them back together by the end. So if you guys are excited for this episode, go ahead and leave a like and let's get into it. My mama always said, girl, you're troubling. And now I wonder, could you fall for a woman like me? Okay, so we've just loaded into the game. Lena is the first one up. It's about 6 in the morning. She's feeling fine, you know, just feeling content. She's gonna come over here and play some dolls. So she just had her birthday. She's feeling really happy from playing with dolls, which is nice. I think I needed to get her to do her homework for today. She seems to wake up really early to get that kind of stuff done, which I think I said in the last episode. It makes sense because Roxanne never regulated, like, you know, her sleep schedule and never like gave her a bedtime or anything like that. Yeah, so she always ends up like sleeping really late and then, you know, getting up super early to like do homework and whatever. And she's still feeling a little tense after, you know, Akira moved in. Obviously he is sleeping in the living room because, you know, obviously Roxanne and him aren't together yet. So he kind of has to just awkwardly sleep in the living room. Which, speaking of, Roxanne, you aren't even tired anymore. So why don't you get up? Get up, go ahead and get some leftovers and maybe, you know, chat with Lena a little bit. Oh, she does have to go into school in an hour. So yeah, definitely chat with her a little bit. You know, just like make small talk, you know, ask her how she slept, how she's doing, you know, oh, how was school yesterday? Little things, you know, she doesn't have a great relationship with her yet. And it's, I think, still gonna take a little bit of time for her to build that up again. But she's trying. She's making an effort to, at least, which is nice. She's not being quite as harsh on her anymore. She's not being quite as mean to her. The only thing I have left for her to do in terms of, like, you know, her aspiration, whatever, is she has to witness the death of a sim. I have no clue how we're gonna do that. Like, I genuinely have no idea. Okay, Akira is up. Go ahead and use the bathroom. And he's also really hungry, so go ahead and get something to eat. Which, Lena, have you... Oh, she hasn't eaten yet either. She has to go to school. Oh no, she's gonna end up being really hungry, but she has to go. Dang it. Okay, that sucks. I'm sorry, Lena. Have a good day at school. Okay, so she just left. I'm gonna still try to have her make some more friends, because she only made one friend in the last episode. So I want her to be able to make some more. These two are just up and chatting. Okay, and Akira has to go to work in an hour as well. So I'm trying to get him promoted as well. He is feeling, I think, a little flirty. Go ahead and play some video games for a little bit. That might help your performance. And Roxanne, you don't work for 3 days. So I don't know what to do with you because... Yeah, me too. Lena has met Lacey. Nice, nice. I'm glad that she's starting to make some more friends. Okay, I would suggest, since she doesn't have work, to, you know, do this night on the town, which he will be home around 7. So maybe after, you know, after he gets home from work today, they can, like, go on a little date or a date. Maybe instead of, like, it being a date, they, you know, just hang out, just talk, you know, spend time together, and then maybe potentially it could turn into a date. Who knows? Okay, so he does have to go into work, and I see that Roxanne is getting a call from the school. Lena spent most of recess running around trying to kiss some of the other students, Why is that so accurate, considering that she is going to be our next generation, which is lust? And she's, I think, going to be a serial romantic, so that's actually kind of perfect. She didn't catch anybody, but the other students were running away. I feel like Roxanne would just be like, it's just kids being kids. Like, who cares? Did she hurt anybody? No? She's fine. All right, Nakira is off to work now, so you go ahead and work hard. Roxanne, dear, what do we do with you today? I can't even like have her hang out with people or anything because like she doesn't have any friends, she doesn't have any family. You know, like she literally is on bad terms with every single person that she's ever spoken to. So I really, the only person that she can like talk to is Akira. So also Dwayne, but like they're not like that close though, you know. So she's just in here cleaning up the house for the time being. I might actually send her on a jog because it's been a little while since I've done that. Lena has met Daryl while at school. I have another sim named Daryl. All right, Roxanne, I'm gonna have you go for a quick jog because it's been a while since you've done that. I need you to hold on to a stack of simoleons. Yeah, take the money. Nice. Oh, but she's feeling flirty. I think she's thinking about Akira and maybe, you know, having plans to go out with him later. I feel like she definitely still likes him. Like, it's awkward right now, but, like, she still likes him. She's trying not to, like, show it, though. She's like, yeah, it's fine. We're just gonna hang out, and it's gonna be good. Like, who cares? But she's kind of, like, Roxanne, maybe don't stand in the middle of the street. Like, please, I don't want you to get hit by a car. Lena has met Luca while at school. Good, okay, I'm glad that she's making more friends. Because I was kind of worried that, like, she was having trouble making friends at school. But it looks like she's actually doing really well. Lena has met Jocelyn. I'm going to have to go and give all her little friends makeovers. I think that would be really cute. We'll see which friends are, like, the most relevant. And then we'll give them makeovers. And Lena should actually be home in just a little bit. So that's actually perfect timing. Okay, so she just came home. She also really needs a shower. Unfortunately, Roxanne is already in the shower, so she's gonna have to wait. Why don't you get a little after-school snack? Oh, she's gonna go and actually talk to her. She's doing that all by herself. Nice. Oh, girl, she is so stinky, smelly. Poor girl. She's like, girl, you need a bath. Like, she's like, thanks, Mom. Thanks. But she's actually coming in to talk to her, and they're starting to sort of build like a friendship, which is nice. I feel like Lena is still a little unsure of how to act around Roxanne. I feel like she's still like, I don't know what to like make of this, you know? Like, my mom never spent any time with me, and now all of a sudden she's spending time with me. Like, now that my dad is here and like living here, all of a sudden she wants to like talk to me, and I don't think she really knows how to handle that right now. But like I said, Roxanne is at least making the effort. She's trying. She's not good at it. She's not, you know, she's not a great mom or even a good mom, but she's trying. She's making the effort. Okay, hang on, girl. Instead of doing that, why don't you get your homework done? And then maybe you can invite over some friends. Or maybe, you know, maybe she can go over to like a friend's house for when Akira and Roxanne go out later. She can maybe go over to a friend's house. Oh, and she's actually sitting in here like doing her homework next to her. And she's actually like talking with her. It is sweet. She's doing her best. Maybe apologize to her. I feel like that would be a good start. Just like, I'm really sorry I haven't been there for you. And like, she's like, I know it's really weird that your dad is here, and like, I know everything is happening kind of so fast. She's like, I'm really sorry that you have to deal with that, but she's like, but I'm gonna try. And she's like, I'm not gonna be perfect. I'm not a good mom, but I'm doing my best. So, you know, yeah. Like, she doesn't really know how to talk to her, and she doesn't really know like what to say, but she's just kind of like, I'm trying, you know? Which, Akira should be home soon. Oh, and he's in the excellent again. He might actually get promoted. That might be a good, you know, a reason for them to, like, go out later. I hope he gets promoted. Oh, Lena finished her homework for the day. That's good. Oh, she's gonna go draw. So yeah, so definitely when Akira gets home, she's gonna go to like a friend's house. Okay, literally with like 3 minutes to spare, we got it. He should be getting promoted.
Nope.
What? It went back. Are you serious? It went back down right at the last second and he didn't get promoted. Okay, fine, whatever. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and send Lena over to a friend's house. These two are feeling kind of tense. So why don't you guys both go out somewhere together? Okay, so we're just gonna go to the bar where we first met. I do wanna place some more, like, I wanna update the, you know, the locations in the save file, but I just haven't really had the chance to yet. So yeah, so we're just gonna come to the bar where they first met. Is that Don? Yep, he is the bartender. Let's come. She has a bad relationship with him. Maybe have Akira come in here and order some drinks for you two. Don, are you not actually the mixologist? She just got some coffee. I'm a little. He can't order any drinks. Okay, weird. So why don't you two come and dance together for a little bit? It's ladies' night. Perfect to have a girls' night out. Well, instead of that, we're hanging out with our ex-boyfriend, so, you know. But at least, you know, they're hanging out, and at least they're talking, they're, you know, dancing a little bit. I would like to get some drinks, but Don over there is apparently not gonna actually tend the bar. He's just gonna sit there sad. It says there's already a mixologist here, but, like, Don isn't tending the bar, so, like, dude. Okay, I guess we aren't gonna get drinks. Okay, Akira, so I'm gonna have you guys sit down over here together. Hopefully a new mixologist will show up. Okay, we got a new mixologist. Hopefully they'll actually like make drinks. But for now, why don't you two just kind of talk for a little bit and just chat, you know? You don't have to flirt or anything right away. He's feeling a little uncomfortable, but maybe talk about the promotion, you know, that you guys got. Have like discuss his uncomfortable mood. Be like, you know, hey, what's wrong? What's going on? And he's feeling better, which is good. Also, Luna, can you get out of our conversation? Like, go away. Okay, so I think this is bugged out because the mixologist is still standing out there and he just disappeared. So it's like free food and drinks and we can't even do that. We can't even get any. Oh, she's actually gonna make drinks? Hang on. Okay, finally, we can actually get a drink. Just get some juice on the rocks. Maybe also get some chips. That might be good as well. Get something to eat for the two of you. All right, so the main thing, like I said, is really just to get their relationship back up. So yeah, let's get them talking. Maybe, you know, confess attraction a little bit. Just be like, hey, I don't want to make things weird, but like, you know, I'm still kind of into you. And God, all these people are throwing me off. I can't hear myself think with all these people standing around. But just, you know, let him know, like, I know this is probably kind of weird, but like, I'm still kind of into you, and like, it's totally fine if you're not, and like, I get it, but I just, you know, thought I should say that. And he's just like, no, I kind of am too. And he's like, I don't want to rush things because I don't want to make you uncomfortable, and I don't want to make Lena, you know, stressed out. You know, before, you know, we kind of rushed things, but maybe just take it a little slow this time. And see how it goes, you know? She's like, yeah, I think that's good. And I think back in the pink, we're not in the red anymore, which is nice. So I think, like I said, this time, you know, they do want to kind of take it slow, but they're also both feeling super flirty. Like, so I don't want to just rush into like woohoos or anything like that. Like, I don't want to, you know, I don't want to like do what we did before and they just kind of rushed into all of that. But they are both so flirty. Girl, why are you like dancing behind me? Can you back up? But yeah, oh my God, just like look at how he looks at her. He's always been so enamored with her. And he's not even drinking. Like, he got her a drink and he's not even drinking anything. I think he's ordering something now though, but okay, yeah, he did end up getting something. Oh my God, all of these people are in this discussion. Can you get out? Too many people. I think I'm gonna have them come sit over here. So like, I don't think they're really gonna rush things, but just kind of taking it slow. And like, we're not gonna jump into woohoos yet. We're not, or at least not right now, but they are still interested in each other, and I think that's really sweet. They are still very much like happy to be together, and that never changed. They're so happy whenever they're around each other. Like, they're just the most happy that they've ever been. Oh god, and he wants to woohoo with her. I just said, Akira, I just said that we're not gonna woohoo. I'll go ahead and pin it though anyway, but we're not gonna do that right now. So it is like 3 a.m. You do have a daughter who was staying at a friend's house. So why don't we get home? In my head, she's spending the night at her friend's house, but obviously she's gonna be there when we get back home. But yeah, so they had a nice little flirtatious date night. They're both feeling really flirty, but we're not gonna woohoo. We're not gonna rush into it. We're just gonna like let it stay the way that that it is right now. Okay, so we are back home and she is exhausted. So go to sleep. Both of y'all get to bed. It's like 4 a.m. It's about 6 and Lena is up. She's gonna have cake for breakfast. Why don't you get some cereal? That might, I think, be better. And it is Saturday, so maybe we can have like a little play date with her friends today. I feel like that would be really fun. And then I know I said I'd probably wait until she was a teenager to like give makeovers to her friends, but like, who knows? I might fix them up a little bit today, just because she's got 10 days before she ages up into a teen. So I might let her hang out with her friends today and give them all like tiny little makeovers. Just so they look better. But for now, it's like 7 a.m, so go ahead and work on your little drawing. Oh, look at these little crafts that she made. That's so cute. Can we put that like above her bed or something? I don't think I can. Okay, hang on. I'll put that over there, actually. We'll leave that there, and then we'll put that above her mirror. I think that's really cute. So Lena is up and she's playing with her little toy in here. She's just talking to it and playing with it. Roxanne should be waking up pretty soon. Akira is still a little tired. So Roxanne, I'm gonna have you wake up now. It's like 9:30. Let's go ahead and get something to eat. She wants to be mean to a child. No, you've stopped doing that. You're not gonna be mean to her anymore. So how should we do our little play date? Should we, I think, maybe start like a little club? I feel like that would be cool for her. And it was just like a little like, you know, just like a little fun like hangout club. Okay, so we can add all these friends from school to her little club. So we've got Daryl, Luca, Heiju, Lacey, and Jocelyn. Okay, and then requirements, you have to be a child. This is just gonna be a fun little club. We're gonna call it the Kids Club, and it's just gonna be by invite only. So that's gonna be Lena's little club, and I want to get everybody to like hang out together. We're gonna go to the park and hang out with her new little group of friends. Okay, so we just started a gathering. All of the kiddos are gonna start coming up. I do wanna give them a little bit of an update, so I'll probably do that when everybody gets here. And I'm just gonna be real quick about it, so I don't plan on, you know, spending too much time. I think all the kiddos are here, so we are going to have everybody come over here just so I can see everybody. So give me just a second, I'm gonna go ahead and give them all a tiny little update, and then we will be right back. Okay, so we've gone ahead and fixed up all the kiddos just a little bit. I didn't spend too much time on them. I didn't mess with their outfits at all, just, you know, their hair and whatnot. So of course we have Lena. We have right here, we have Jocelyn, we have Luca, and we have Lacey. And then, oh, there's some other kids here actually. I might want to be friends with them too. Here we have Heiju right here. Kind of hard to see her, but there's her. And then we have little Daryl over here. So this is the current club. I might actually be able to redeem some spots like for extra members, because then I can actually ask maybe these two if they want to be in our club. Who are you? We've got Noemi Landgram. I'm going to go ahead and friendly introduction to you. And then we've got, what is your name? Masato. So we're going to go ahead and give you a friendly introduction as well. Yeah, so for now, I just want to see, like, you know, who she ends up being, like, friends with and who ends up being the most relevant. I do want her to just, I want her to be able to, like, make friends, because it's going to be, you know, part of her, like, storyline, you know, that she's supposed to be, like, pretty popular. She's going to eventually go on a lot of dates and all that. So I want to kind of make connections now. Oh, there's another kiddo. Hello. Christy Caliente, I'm gonna make friends with you too. Yeah, so we've got a whole little like group of kiddos here. I would add them to my club, but I can't yet. Oh, we've got Luca over here making a mess while this poor adult is coming over to clean up after all of these kids. This is so many kids. I think my favorite out of the kiddos so far, I really like Luca. he's a cutie. I kind of like all of them though. Like Daryl is pretty cute. Heiju is really cute. Yeah, so I definitely want to get her like talking with everybody because I want her to make like friends with all of them. We do need to make friends for her social butterfly aspiration, which is not something I have to complete, but I want to, you know? We've learned that Daryl is active. Okay. Also, Heiju is like all the way over here by herself. Come on. We've learned that Jocelyn is an art lover. That's nice. Poor Heiju, she doesn't want to like hang out with the rest of the group. Like, I guess she's... Is she gonna come over now? Because everybody's like standing in a circle talking and she's just kind of like on the outside. Oh, Akira's calling. Hey, honey, it's dad. When are you gonna... Okay, I'm gonna take this as like he's like, hey, when are you coming home? Okay, I'll be home soon, dad. It's like 3 p.m. Let her have some fun. We haven't made one friend yet. She's just been like kind of talking with all of them, but she hasn't specifically made like friends with any of them yet. Maybe we'll start with Heiju. It's kind of hard to like make friends with everybody all at once, you know? You're really great, Heiju. She was like the first friend that she like met at school, so I feel like we should, you know, definitely put in effort to like make her our friend. Also because she seems to be a little like shyer. Aw, but these two are cute. They're sweet. She's reached social level 6 already. Wow. Oh, she likes comedy. Okay, sure. She is gonna be in the entertainer career. I think she might be a musician, but I mean, who knows? If she likes comedy, she might end up being a comedian. You're so awesome, Heiju. Aw, that's very sweet of her. It might be a little cheaty for me to do this, but I'm gonna have her take photos with everybody just to kind of like, you know, get like a boost. Because otherwise it's gonna take so long for her to be friends with everybody. And she's already reached social level 7. Aw, look at them. They're really cute. I feel like they're gonna be good friends. They're super adorable. All right, go take a picture with Jocelyn. I feel like Lena would be the type to like make a little scrapbook with like all of her like friends' pictures in them. I feel like that would be really cute. Okay, so we got a bit of a boost with Jocelyn. Okay, go ahead and take a picture with Lacey. Oh my god, I'm not gonna be able to get them in the frame together. Oh my goodness. This is like, I wish you could zoom out. Why can you not like, why is there no way to like zoom out? All right, Luca's next. Aw, he's a cutie. He's really adorable. They look like they could be siblings, actually. They look a lot alike. Okay, but we actually made our first friend with Luca. That's really cute. Okay, and then I think we still have a couple more. Let's go take a picture with Daryl. Aw, he's cute too. All of them are really cute. I'm excited to see what they're all gonna look like as teenagers. And I'm also excited to see if she ends up having any interest in them when they become teenagers. Okay, so now she's taking pictures with everybody. Look at those two being cute over there. So now she's taking pictures with everyone, so she should hopefully now have an easier time making friends with all of them. Although it looks like Daryl, she didn't really get that much of a boost with him. I wonder if isn't really like a picture person. Same with Lacey and Jocelyn. Interesting. It is past 7, so it is getting kind of late, Lena, for you to be out here by yourself. So I'm gonna let her finish up this conversation with Heiju really quick, because I want them to actually hit friends, because they're still just acquaintances for some reason. She does need a BFF, which I kind of wanted it to be Heiju just because she was the first friend that she got. Okay, Lena, it's time to head home. But she seems to actually have been closer with Luca first. It seems like Luca was actually the first like one that she got a big boost with. So I kind of wonder like which one of the two she'll kind of gravitate to, you know, as they get older, as they hang out more, if she'll be best friends with Luca or if she'll be best friends with Heiju, or if she'll just have a completely different best friend. I'm kind of curious. But for now it is 8 p.m. and she is finally home. Have you done your homework yet? Yeah, she did. Oh my god, she took like almost 40 photos. But I feel like she would be the type to like, you know, put like pictures of like her and her friends all like up on her walls and stuff. That's super cute. So I'm going to go ahead and just put these up on her wall, like right above her bed. I think that's super cute. And then I saw that we also actually got a bunch of stuff in our household inventory. So a couple of these things I can definitely keep, like this coffee pot would be really nice. Put that right over here. And then she's got a punching bag, and then she's got a bunch of stuff from her criminal career, which I think we're just going to sell because even though she still is in the criminal career, I think that, you know, once she gets married or like once, you know, she and Akira get back together, I think she might retire from that career. I don't really know yet. I'll leave the punching bag for now, though, because that'll be useful for her fitness. But yeah, for now, like, I'm not really sure what exactly she's going to do with the criminal career because she never really... I feel like her and Akira have kind of talked since then. I know beforehand, like, he didn't really know what she did and... she didn't really want him to find out, but I feel like kind of been able to talk about it, and they've, you know, she told him that like she didn't really have much of a choice. That was kind of the only job she could get and, you know, the only thing she was good at. So she felt like she needed to do that. But I don't know, man, she gets a lot of money from that career. So I'm kind of like, maybe we'll save up our money first and then consider quitting that career because we make bank from the criminal career, just saying. Okay, Roxanne, I'm gonna send you into bed. And she does actually go to work tomorrow, so that's good. And then Akira, do you actually work today? No, he's actually off for 2 days. Oh no, Roxanne, stop breaking the... Oh my God, are you serious? Girl, are you kidding me? Fix that right now before Lena wakes up. Are you serious? Why don't you go for a run? Maybe that'll help you get some anger out. Oh, perfect timing because Lena actually just woke up. It's okay. The dollhouse was never broken. She does want to be friendly with Roxanne, so I think her relationship with Roxanne is definitely getting better. It's definitely not great. Like, they're not friends. They're still just acquaintances. Actually, she's only acquaintances with both of her parents. Even though Akira has been, you know, really present and trying to shower her with affection and gifts that she, you know, never got as a toddler, I feel like she still is kind of like, she doesn't really know him all that well, so it's still like kind of awkward, you know. But I really hope that Lena can actually bond with both of her parents. That would be really nice. Go ahead and get some food. Maybe this would be the perfect opportunity to chat more with your dad. Maybe talk about your favorite animal with him. Tell a make-believe story. I just want them to bond. Okay, Roxanne, I think it's your turn to bond with your daughter a little bit, you know. Try to talk to her. Maybe try to get to, you know, friends and not just acquaintances. Ask about her day. Ask about, you know, yesterday when she went out with all her friends. Oh, that is the first time that she has ever hugged her daughter. That is the first time she has ever done that. But she's reached parenting level 6 already, though, which is hilarious because she's never been a good parent. Okay, Akira, why don't you come in here and chat with them as well? You guys can all hang out together. Oh, where are you guys going? Okay. Are we going out here? Oh, okay. She's walking away and they're hugging it out. Why don't you guys watch a movie together? Aww. Wait, that's so cute. This is adorable, you guys. He loves her so much. They're cuddling while they watch their little movie together. All right, so Roxanne is coming in here just to play some video games by herself. But, oh, speaking of video games, actually, I do need to get... I do need to get Akira to play some video games so he'll get his skill up. Okay, for now though, I want to focus on, God, her skills. She is rocking that social skill. We're gonna work on getting your creativity up. Why don't you draw for a little bit? And Akira's feeling kind of flirty, so why don't you come in here, talk with Roxanne for a little bit? He does want to kiss somebody, so maybe give her a little kiss. Aw, these two. He does want to be funny with her as well, so let's go ahead and tell her a joke, try to make her laugh. So these two are just chatting. They're, you know, they're taking it slow. They're still technically not official yet, but I mean, they have been romantic with each other. But for now, like, they are trying to kind of ease into it instead of, like, jumping in. She does still, like, really want to woohoo with them, though, and I think... But he also really wants to woohoo with her, too. He's like trying, I think, to hold himself back and be like, no, I told her we would take it slow. I told her that, you know, that we didn't have to do anything if, you know, she didn't want to or if she felt uncomfortable. But even Roxanne is kind of just like, I kind of want to, though. And like, I think she misses him. And I feel like being around him more, when he wasn't around, she could ignore it. And she could be like, no, it's fine. I don't need him. You know, I can live my own life and whatever. But I think now that he's here all the time and she sees him every single day, I feel like it's just making her miss him like all that much more, even though he's like in the same house as her. But yeah, I mean, they both really want to. Like, I know I said I would take it slow, but just they both really want to. So I think I will let them. What if this ends up in another baby though? I literally didn't even think about that until like I already got them started. Oh no. From first? Woohoo. It wasn't your first, believe me. I guarantee that was not your first. She is a little tense. Oh my god. Oh my god, wait. Is she Is she pregnant? Is she pregnant? Oh no. Oh my god. Oh my god. Of course. Of course. Oh no. Okay, you guys, so I guess I'll just leave it there for today. I guess we're gonna have another baby on the way, which, like, Roxanne didn't even really want one, so Roxanne was, she was finally, like, getting comfortable with this life, with, like, having her one kid. Let me just double check the rules really quick. I just checked the rules just to make sure. There's not a requirement that you can't have more than one. I really didn't picture Roxanne having more than one. She definitely didn't want more than one. She was finally getting used to like this life with Akira and Lena, and now they have another baby on the way. Oh my god. And there she goes, off to work. Okay, you guys, so I am gonna go ahead and end this episode for today. I really was not expecting there to be another surprise pregnancy right at the end of that episode. Of course, the one time that I let them do it after they haven't seen each other for like this many years and she gets pregnant again. But I think this time will be a little easier. Roxanne, I'm sure, is going to be very tense about it, but I think this time will be easier because she has Akira here. And this time, like, he's in it. Like, he's ready and he's like, don't worry, I'm going to help you. And like, we're gonna get through this together. So I feel like now that Akira is present, I feel like this is going to be a lot easier on Roxanne this time. But let me know what you guys thought of this episode in the comments below. Let me know if you guys have any name suggestions for the new baby. I genuinely was not anticipating another baby, but I guess this is happening. So if you guys have any name suggestions, go ahead and leave those down in the comments below. If you enjoyed this episode, don't forget to leave a like and hit the subscribe button so you guys won't miss out on the next episode when it comes out. And as always, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Bye-bye.